The hidden cost of free email. Protecting what matters before it's gone. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I hear from people who lose their email accounts permanently with alarming regularity. It applies to social media accounts too, but here I'm going to focus on email. Email seems to be the most lucrative target for hackers and the most important to the account holder. It's quite possible to use free email accounts like Outlook.com, Gmail, Yahoo Mail, and others safely. Let's dive into exactly how. You first need to be aware of several risks that come with free email: a lack of customer service, being the target for hackers, and difficulties accessing your account while traveling. Most importantly is the lack of customer support. If something goes wrong, you are on your own. The problem is that any customer support, particularly good customer support, is expensive. The result is that free services don't provide any. Instead, they may offer online knowledge bases and forums, which offer varying levels of usefulness in emergencies. Think of no customer support as the real cost of using a free email service. Hackers know that first point. They know there's no help for victims of their hacks. That means that once they gain access to an account, it's likely they'll keep access to that account forever. In addition, they can get access to your address book, meaning they can send spam and scam emails that look like they came from you. Your free account is very valuable to hackers. And of course, one of the biggest causes of temporary and sometimes permanent account lockout is not due to hackers, but travel. Because email services are constantly fighting hacking attempts, they treat sudden access from locations you don't normally frequent as signs of potential concern. That means they may throw additional security steps in your way to confirm it's really you. If you can't respond to those additional challenges, which is common if you're traveling and you're not prepared, they may lock you out. It's an accident that happens all too often. So, even in the face of the risk, it's quite possible to use free email accounts safely. I do it myself. Here are four essential steps to take. One, back up. You saw this coming. In order to protect yourself from potentially losing your account and everything in it, you should back up everything in it. Normally, that means your email and contacts, but include anything else related to the services provided by the account provider. As a start, use a desktop email client, like say Thunderbird, to download emails to a PC that you then back up separately as well. Other content, like contacts, might need to be backed up manually, so maybe set yourself a reminder. Number two, set up recovery information. I am shocked at how many people refuse to give their free email service a phone number. I'm not shocked at how many of those people then end up losing their account because they have no recovery account information associated with it. Set up a phone number to get a text, or an alternate email address to get a code, or whatever other recovery information might be requested. It could mean, heck, it will mean the difference between recovering the account or losing it forever. Number three, update the recovery information. I include this as a separate step because honestly, it might be the number one reason that accounts are lost. Account recovery information has been set up, which is great, but when the time comes to use it, too many people find out that they no longer have that phone number or they don't have access to that email account they originally listed for recovery. Keep the recovery information up to date or, once again, risk losing your account forever. Number four, add two-factor authentication. You know, I used to say consider it, but my recommendation is much stronger these days. Just do it. Two-factor authentication protects your account from hacking even if the hacker figures out your password. It's not nearly the hassle many people think it is, and it's a powerful level of additional security. Just be sure to add and keep recovery information up to date and keep any recovery codes that the two-factor setup process offers in a safe place. Now, If all that is too much effort, or you don't trust free email accounts after hearing about the risks involved, that's fine. Pull out your credit card instead. Paid email providers should offer a much better level of customer support. In addition, they have this additional, I guess I'd call it a second factor of sorts, your credit card. Your use of and your ability to provide your credit card information is another way your paid provider knows you are you and should be authorized back into a compromised account. When shopping around for a paid email service, be sure to make sure that their support options meet your needs. Bottom line, you know, all accounts come with risks. They do. But free email accounts are some of the riskier accounts you might end up using. Take the additional steps I've outlined to avoid the risk to begin with and or recover more smoothly from issues if or when they arise. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/179682. If you've got a question, visit askleo.com/ask. If you're interested in my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, askleo.com/newsletter. And if you're interested in helping me do what I do, visit askleo.com/patron for a few options. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.